A woman walks through the train station at night.
Exterior. Houses with gardens on both sides. Now they begin to light the candles. They give each other knowing looks, as if approving of her decision to quit.
It was not long ago that we shared that meal together, and she seemed at ease, happy even, but I didn't know her well enough to know how frequently she was happy, or if it was a rather different state of being for her, if I should have been more attentive to it, if it was due to our evening in particular, what we were discussing, or its general qualities, ending a night with a friend, headed home, an embrace goodbye. What's not to feel happy or comforted even about? Sometimes, once in an evening, out of many, a feeling strikes you in a way that stands out, your other hours chill in comparison, a relook entirely at how you're feeling or how your dinner is unfolding, however it is. Am I right? It's possible near the end. She was happy in a way she had not been for some time, but how would I have known that it was a remarkable moment for her? If this was a night unlike the other nights that could have startled her into a hope that I had no idea was forming. Anyway, it's not the point, I suppose. Since then, she has remained mostly silent.
I went down to the basement and he followed me. It was very frustrating. We had an awkward moment. I was looking for a retreat with no intimacy. I stopped short on the step, turned and pressed myself against the wall, and he laughed at me, not understanding the game. I was trying to get around him. Finally, I did, and he was in front of me on the stairs. Outside, I heard the buzz of some electric machine.
For the definition of my kind must somehow be made to resonate as my own as I pass from my truth in private to my truth in the world.
I pushed him. Fortune had it we were at the bottom step. The downstairs door was open, and our backyard stretched out before us. Its green tints in the darkness were waiting for him.
Now they begin to polish the silverware.
Go lie down in the grass.
I don't feel much like it.
I need to pick up my daughter at some point.
Oh my God.
It says to mouth it. I mean, you do want me to say it? Yeah? Got it. Say it. Okay, sorry. Oh my God!
Do you want a ride?
I already told you to wait for me.
So. Yeah, okay.
I mean, I'm not sure I know what you want, really. Oh my God! No, that's not right. I just need to find my... I have a pen here somewhere.
Hello? Why am I afraid of the truth?
IHHOH! On hearing that, every Freemason must come to help those who have given it. You're gonna help me? No. I can see it. I have a place in mind that will be ideal if only I could resurrect or find the language behind the actual language. It's okay, yeah. I know. It's, fine.
It's, just a moment.
Oh, yeah. Just a moment. One moment. I don't have to tell you. I mean, you're the only one. Can we just start from the part where... Oh, they always play the same songs at that restaurant. Yes, I noticed it, too. I certainly wasn't expecting to meet him. I mean, I was dating this painter at the time, and... But here was this person, on the second day of the shoot, standing near a boat, quite like a pelican. My heart leapt from my chest, I just knew. Of course, he was lively and handsome, and really startling, actually. So he slipped me a note under the table, touched my leg lightly. No stress, no. Really, I mean, do I seem stressed? The note read, I had to sneak into the bathroom to read it, but it read, "Meet me at room number 302 at 9:30. I won't forget it." I mean, of course, the painter read it over my shoulder after sneaking into the bathroom behind me, and he got very upset. I was all done by then, anyhow. I ran out of the place. I had some kind of gravy all over my chest. I'm not sure how that happened, but I was very startled and very in love. Of course, the painter, this poor boy, he was chasing after me.
Was he diabetic? Was he diabetic? Borderline diabetic?
Okay, it's become a scenario I can comprehend. Got it. She sees the...
Timpani?
Yeah, the timpani down the hallways. There is more than one hallway.
Yeah, there's a bunch of...
You don't really need more than one.
It's a lot.
Oh my God!
So did you meet him?
Well, the problem was... You know, I woke up in his hotel room the next morning, but he was gone. He disappeared. Yes, we were inseparable after that.
Our marriage is a success, isn't it? A great success.
Wonderful.
Yeah, that's better.
I think so.
marriage is a success, isn't it?
Wonderful.
A great success. Wonderful? Okay. Our marriage is a success, isn't it? A wonderful success.
If you say so, it's all right.
Oh, dear. This all started because I broke the China Cupid.
Damn the Cupid.
Was it very valuable?
Mm-hmm.
Was it very valuable?
I forget.
Hmm?
I've forgotten.
Okay, the line is, what, our marriage is a success, isn't it a great success?
Our marriage is a success, isn't it a great success?
Wonderful.
That's better.
That's better.
Oh, that's better.
I think so.
Our marriage is a success. Yeah. Wonderful.
Great.
Great.
Ha. Huh.
The line is, our marriage is a success, isn't it? A great success.
Our marriage is a success, isn't it? A great success.
Wonderful.
But...
No, ah, wonderful.
Ah, wonderful. Our marriage is a success, isn't it? A wonderful success.
Yeah.
If you say so, it's all right.
Oh dear. This all started when I broke the China Cupid.
Damn the Cupid.
Was it very valuable?
I know. I know that one already.
Oh, okay.
Was it very valuable?
Hmm.
What was it very valuable?
I forget.
Yes. Yes.
Hmm?
Oh, no. No, it's nothing.
Hmm?
I've forgotten.
I see. That's enough for now. I'd like to phone someone. You understand and repeat where. Where? Good. You're not going? No, sir. It's you who are going. Did you really think he was my uncle? I met him at the theater. Now I have a line. I've 10 lines to learn. Dear counselor, it is getting late, and I am tired of waiting for you. My dear counselor, the night is closing in, and the day's affairs have caused my mind to meet such nocturnal reckoning with a most unfortunate blasé. Please hurry.
My one and only confidant, I see only darkness, no matter the time. We must try harder. I hope to have you in my arms before I am swallowed whole by the queen of the night, who is to be destroyed by the awful sun wizard on account of her revolutionary potential. He has ordered it on the count of 10. She will take us all with her into a most impossible void. I love you. 1.
Two. 3.
Hello?
So, the books were written for money?
Well, and for fun. I mean, for money and fun. It's all in the preface to The Night. Shall I read it to you?
No.
I mean, as we needed money, I decided to write a fake novel, which was like a kind of a joke on the popular novels of the time. I followed that with The Night, which was a kind of a joke on the new novelists. I mean, the new novelist was kind of the peak of modernity at the time. I mean, we were probably more modern, who knows? But nobody knew us. As for the new novelists, I mean, were they really even a group? It was good for the media. I mean, they had the same publishers. They were in the same photos. But I mean, the books were really quite different. Some of them I liked a lot.
How was The Night received by other members of your friends?
Well, I don't know. I mean, in the end, there's just a little bitterness, like a hangover. Will disappear. That's life.
What?
I mean, the problem was not being interested or not in art. I mean, the problem was a total absence of artists in the group after their exclusion.
So the books were written for fun?
I mean, we've been married for 11 years. You know what happens after 11 years. You fall in love with someone else. Not just a little affair, but really in love. So he fell in love with Sabrina, and I fell in love with someone who wasn't very important, but who was very dear to me at the time.
Belinda.
You have something on your face.
Oh no, it's just my face. It's already like that. It's fine. No, I got it. No, it's fine. I got it.
Yeah, it's okay now.
At times, the shrill notes of locusts in a meadow petrified by the sun and as though dead induce the sensation of cold, of solitude, of abandonment in a hostile universe in which something anguishing is impending. In the silence, penetrating the length of the old blue-striped wallpaper in the hall, the length of the dingy paint, she heard the little click of the key in the front door. She heard the study door close. She remained there hunched up, waiting, doing nothing. The slightest act, such as going to the bathroom to wash her hands, letting the water run from the tap, seemed like a provocation, a sudden leap into the void, an extremely daring action. In the suspended silence, the sudden sound of water would be like a signal, like an appeal directed towards them. It would be like some horrible contact, like touching a jellyfish with the end of a stick, and then waiting with loathing for it suddenly to shudder, rise up, and fall back down again. She sensed them like that, spread out, motionless, on the other side of the walls and ready to shudder, to stir. She did not move, and about her, the entire house, the street, seemed to encourage her, seemed to consider this motionlessness natural. It appeared certain when you opened the door and saw the stairway filled with relentless, impersonal, colorless calm, a stairway that did not seem to have retained the slightest trace of the persons who had walked on it, not the slightest memory of their presence, when you stood behind the dining room window and looked at the house fronts, the shops, the old women and little children walking along the street, it seemed certain that, for as long as possible, she would have to wait, remain motionless like that, do nothing, not move, that the highest degree of comprehension, real intelligence, was that to undertake nothing, keep as still as possible, do nothing. At the most, by being careful not to wake anybody, you could go down without looking at the dark, dead stairway and proceed unobtrusively along the pavements, along the walls, just to get a breath, to move about a bit, without knowing where you were going, without wanting to go anywhere, and then come back home, sit down on the edge of the bed, and once more wait, curled up, motionless. You smell like a daffodil.
Do you hear that?
Yeah.
Walking through the train station at night.